But for a house to be sold, it's best for it to be empty.
There's a whole house empty down there. There's hundreds of rooms. They're all empty. And they're not putting anybody in them, and they're just waiting there.
For leaving them empty. We can't seem to find out why they're leaving the
property
empty.
They won't let anybody else.
Some of them are empty.
Next door to me,
years.
There's six rooms empty. My sister lives in a council flat. She'd do anything to live in that house and have this garden. Where in London would you get a lovely garden like this? It's wicked.
What do you think has made this change in the company, in the company's policy?
Greed, probably.
The houses, since they lie just 1 mile from St. Paul's, are very attractive propositions for buyers. Given a facelift, they are now fetching prices of up to £50,000. That's twice as much as when the process started. Tenants who rent their homes feel uneasy.
I mean, well-off people with money, they don't want to mix with ordinary people. They only want, really, they're in centre of London for their business, and probably they've got a lovely country house for the weekends and everything, haven't they?
Not that we don't want outsiders moving in, but they all seem to be what we call posh people, you know. And we just like it, wanted to stay the way it was, with the nice families and children and all that. And we just don't want it to change.
We get a good community here. It's from King's Cross Road up to the St. John's Street. It's like a village. Everybody's ever so friendly.
They've altered these houses into flats, haven't they?
£26,000 for a flat. Well, who the hell was going to pay that?
These flats are more pricey than for the likes of us, aren't they?
£48,000, the house, on the corner.
A different class of people coming around here now, isn't it?
The flats, £27,000.
As I say, making them into these houses into flats, that's one of the things.
If you're a millionaire or any moneyed person, you
really, I think they just want to sell all their property.
At the beginning of the 60s, the company's estate was valued at £1.5 million. The city is now keenly interested in the company's potential.
If you ever decided to sell all those houses to their tenants, the fortune in that company is enormous.
How much would it be?
I don't know. But, you know, I'm not an estate agent. I'm a stockbroker. But I can have a good guess. There are 500 houses there, or something like that. 500 houses at £40,000 a house, or might be too much. There's £20 million.
To the tenants, the new pressures of big business are baffling.
We're wondering, you see, why it's happening. I've got no idea. There's so many in it now, isn't there? So many people in it now, property developers, you see. Where it was only used to be the New River Company, didn't it? You see, years and years ago. But it's all changed now, you see, these property developers. Yes.